Comcast Sportsnet coverage of Capitals hockey being brought to you by GEICO, saving people money on more than just car insurance. Jeep. Visit Jeep.com to learn more. Papa John's. If the Caps win and score four or more goals, get 50% off any online order tomorrow at participating Papa John's locations. And by Sport Automotive Chevrolet and Honda. John Carlson's a sport fan. Be one too. Visit SportAutomotive.com. The beautiful city of Vancouver playing host to NHL action this Sunday night. First of two meetings this season between the Washington Capitals and the Vancouver Canucks. It's all yours from inside of Rogers Arena. Joe Beninati, Craig Lachlan, Alan May with you tonight. Washington coming in with a mark of 4-1-2. Vancouver at 4-3 as Locker details the netminder.
Well, Justin Peters gets the nod for the visitors. Let's go, Justin. 1-0-1 on the season, 1.50, 9-1-9. Picked up the win last Saturday against FLA, 2-1. Ryan Miller gets the nod. 4 wins and 5 tries, a high GAA, a save percentage that you usually expect to be higher. It caps off the crowd, their netminder tonight.
Head coach Barry Trotz matching wits with the new head coach here in Vancouver, Willie Desjardins. Vancouver in the blue sweaters. Washington finishing up this road swing in white. We're glad you've tuned in with us this evening. The on-ice officials, the referees are Ian Walsh and Brad Watson. Matt McPherson and Trent Knorr have the lines.
Right off the get-go, D-to-D puck possession really is a factor for both these hockey clubs. The Caps want to go to D-to-D and then get it up. Quick D change already for the Caps just 7 seconds into this first period.
Nicholas Backstrom drawing against his fellow Swedish Olympic teammate Henrik Sedin. Tanev working out of his own zone, scales to center. John Carlson on the run for Washington. Bad pass. Verbot is in. He lost it on the deke, and then Peters scrambles back to make a glove save.
Yeah, they're really taking away the Caps' D-to-D pass. You can see it right off the get-go. If the Caps are going to be a little careless and casual, plays like that will happen. Carlson did not realize that they were coming with so much pressure at 2-1-2 forecheck. Here it is, Carlson just getting it and just immediately passes it. But when they're taking away both D, that's exactly where their coach Verbata, and they want him there. And they're going to like that little turnover early on.
That was almost lightning in a bottle twice in succession. Remember, Henrik Sedin scored 10 seconds into the game in Denver, a game in which the Canucks were run over by the Avalanche. Chimera lets this one fly, gobbled up by Ryan Miller, and there's no rebound.
Sharp angle shot from Jason Chimera. Way to go, Jason. Big celebration tonight for his 800th game against Ryan Miller and company. He's been around a long time. Coming out west, he always loves that. Chimmer has been a real workhorse for the Caps.
Fans just saw the lineups at the top of the screen for both sides. Washington staying put. Ditto for Vancouver. Cam Hughes on through Matthias. Cassian was cut off by Carl Alsner, a British Columbia native in his own right, 27 in the white. Cassian turns on Niskanen, a backhander that goes wide of the goal. Cam Hughes, straight ahead. The defender, Bieksa, rumbles in, drops it back behind Justin Peters. Justin making his third appearance of the young season. Cam Hughes on target for Cassian, former Sabre first-round draft pick. Challenged by Andre Burakovsky. Bieksa let it come through. Bonino on for Chris Higgins. Burrows with a drive, shouldered down by Peters. Higgins twists it into the corner. Bonino, who played collegiately at Boston University, on the overlap with Higgins, kniping to the net, pad save, Peters. Schmidt to the rescue for Washington and right up the gut. He'll come with Burakovsky, who lost the handle.
It's going to be important for the Caps to get their legs early. This team's coming off a road trip. Usually you can jump on them early, but right now they're jumping on the Caps. Having played last night with a day off, they look pretty quick so far here in the first.
No morning skate for Washington. Burakovsky with a laser that was snapped over the crossbar. Caps had meetings in the hotel here. Johansson finds Carlson. A video exchange of reports on what to expect from the Canucks. No score in this one. Tonight, Alan May inside the glass, sort of.
Yeah, sort of. I'm down here in a mess of people, and that's kind of what the Capitals are going to have to get through tonight, because the way the Canucks are playing this season, they're playing a lot faster game. They're playing to the strengths of their players. And Locker, you talked about that D-to-D pass. That's not going to be there, so the players are going to have to fake that pass, come back, and hit the center and try to come down the ice with a center lane net drive and make sure that they're not passing up opportunities to shoot that puck.
Three guys on the ice for Washington now, Alan. The forwards out there on this line, big smiles on their faces all throughout the evening as we were making our way from Calgary to Vancouver. Latta, O'Brien, and Ward were outstanding last night. They'll backtrack as Henrik Sedin motors in with his brother Daniel. This is offside against Vancouver. Folks, he's the man with all the answers, right or wrong. Here's Craig's voice on value.
It's all about rush hour, Joe B. and Alan May tonight. The Caps off have to use their speed, get their feet moving. Rush against Vancouver. That's exactly what the Lance did. I know it was the end of a road trip, but they rung up the seventh spot because they attacked with speed. That has to be the mandate for the Caps here tonight.
Those words presented by Morgan Franklin Consulting. Caps and Canucks 3 minutes deep in a scoreless first period. Just the second time in his career, Justin Peters has squared off with Vancouver. Fair's outlet was snared by Burrows. Twists it back on to Bonino, the former Anaheim Duck. Nice moves around Green, but Ovechkin is there to support. Fair working through center, drifting wide, and leaving it back behind the cage. Edler to Burrows. One touch passing, and away comes Higgins, who is plastered by Ovechkin as Burrows will dump it in. Desjardins wants the line change.
Alex has had two great hits already, that last one and one earlier against Edler, the defenseman. He's out to crush right off the get-go. When he gets involved physically, more often than not, he's better on the offensive side of things. Good start for the captain.
You're exactly right, Locker. And one of the things when he does get those hits early, you know that he's going to send a lot more pucks towards the front of the net. And when he's in that area of around 10 shots, whether it's shots on net, blocked, or misses, the more pucks he fires, the better he plays.
Vey, snapshot towards the goal, stopped there by Peters. Swing and a miss from the defender who was creeping in. That was Lucas Pisa. Loose in front, protected there by Alsner. Kuznetsov did not get it clear. He'll have a second chance for Chimera, who ladles it back onto the Vancouver side. Beagle's drive snared by Ryan Miller, and he'll hang on. A night after a rambunctious performance for Ovechkin in Calgary, he starts the same way in Vancouver.
Here he is going to the corner, and this is the Edler hit. Watch him finish after he makes the pass. Great finish right there. Then in the neutral zone, another kabong. A couple of kabongs by number 8 already here on the road.
Troy Brouwer set to take this draw, lined up opposite of Brad Richardson, who is excused from the dot by the linesman Knorr.
And this is where they have not been very good this year. With the loss of Kessler, they've really struggled. 29th overall in winning draws. There they got some support and help to win that one in the offensive zone.
The subtraction of Ryan Kessler via the trade. Johansson scampers back through center and he'll drive it in. Brouwer in hot pursuit. Bieksa on for Kassian. Twisting back through center, it's Richardson with his stick lifted by Burakovsky. Brooks Orpik, Niskanen. Burakovsky didn't cleave. Richardson pulls the trigger, had that one blocked by Orpik, and it's out of play. Folks, this evening's cold hard facts are brought to you by Frost Brewed Coors Light.
Caps so much better in holding opponents to less than 30 shots. Caps have done it 7 straight times. The last time the Caps had a streak of 8 games in a row was back in 08. One of the mandates for Coach Barry Trotz when he watched a lot of film this summer was to cut down on the shots against. Well, they indeed have, hovering right around the 24 shots against a game.
Washington has allowed the fewest shots of any team in the Eastern Conference so far this season. They only gave up 21 a night ago.
And out west, only the Wild and Blues, less overall when you look at volumes of shots.
Ricochet to the front, swatted wide by Ovechkin on his backhand. Tanev digging in on Backstrom. Tanev will start back. A bad outlet pass there. Sent back into the zone by Nate Schmidt. 5.5 minutes deep in this opening frame. one and only visit to Rogers Arena for the Washington Capitals, who have not won here since Valentine's Day of 2001. Offside, Canucks on the rush.
Alex Ovechkin throwing around his body. Sometimes you get it, sometimes you don't. He hopes to hit more often than miss. Here's Tanev, seeing the freight train coming. Train out of Alex Ovechkin, number eight, train number eight. Just misses Tanev down low. You look at his season totals, nice tidy number at the end, plus one, playing very more responsible when it comes to five-on-five hockey.
Locker and Allen, when you can, weigh in on this. Ovechkin was under 18 minutes last night. Would you think it was by design with a back-to-back?
I think it was, and that was by design because Barry Trotz talked to us before the game. He said, you know what, if Calgary's going to roll four lines, we thought, why not roll four lines so we'll be fresher tonight.
Great moves by Higgins. I don't know if he needed the last one. It allowed Mike Green to recover.
You're exactly right. I thought he had the inside track. He should have just kept skating, Joe B. What do you always tell me? Less is more, don't you?
That would have been enough. He undressed Mike Green, and then he came back to him.
He's always had those type of hands. Look at that. Inside, outside. The right toe comes to the rescue as Greeny was beat to the middle.
Chris Higgins, Long Island, New York native, in his early 30s now. Where does the time go? Hamhuis towards the cage and wide. Brooks Orpik was there on patrol as this is golfed out by Liam O'Brien. Barry Trotz with a line change on the fly. Yannick Hansen cruising in, lets this one go right to the chest of Peters. Hansen chasing down the rebound, works the cycle with Vey. Lyndon Vey, former LA Kings property. Matt Niskanen on the clear ahead. Chimera, Beagle, and Kuznetsov on ice right now. Off the indirect, it's Dorsett. Hard-nosed customer. At point position, Bieksa to a better shooting lane. He fires. That's deflected over the head of Peters.
And on that play, Kuznetsov's got to go through the man. Instead, he went to the boards. That allowed Bieksa at all time, a ton of time at the point to get that blast through, Joe B.
Cassian will wind it up. Play it for Hamhuis. Cassian takes the return, snapshot right on, and Peters deep in the paint. Need the stop.
Yeah, he's been the difference so far. They've had three real good quality chances. Cassian really using his speed and size going wide against the Caps defenders.
A long lead for Brouwer. The Capitals being outshot to this point 7-2 in the first 8 minutes of the game. Objects in the mirror, closer than they appear along the backboards. Burakovsky twisted on around for Brouwer, upset there by Edler. Another Swedish Olympian on the rink tonight. The hard shooting Edler plays it off the boots of Zach Cassian. He'll clear down. Desjardins will get a line change. Schmidt on the quick up. Johansson wants to check out as well. Verbata for Sedin. Daniel Sedin on the crisscross with Henrik. Daniel fires. That's weakened by Niskanen on the way. Ovechkin turning and burning the other direction. On the crisscross drop with Fair. That backhand was blunted by Yannick Weber. Ovechkin steals. Slots it for Backstrom, and he yanked that one wide. Niskanen towards the cage. Rejected by Weber, who will get help from Lucas Spezza. He heard the footsteps. So Ovechkin then dropped Spezza in his tracks.
Counter hit by OV, saw Spezza coming, down he goes.
No score in this one, approaching the 9 minute mark.
Guys, as time has gone on this road trip, the Capitals have been so much more intense on the puck, and we haven't really seen them play like this in the last few years, and it's not a knock on any of the coaching staff, but they're so much more tough on the puck. There's more intensity. There's a grittier effort. They're finishing in their hits. You look at Alexander Ovechkin, the leader. He's skating two, three extra strides to finish his hits. You see the fourth line last night, Barry Trotz couldn't keep him off the ice because of how they were playing. And, you know, that's not because they were cutting Ovi's ice, but the fourth line played so well because they were tenacious, probably the toughest line on the puck all night long.
Just about every press conference Barry Trotz has, Alan, he uses the word dog as a verb. We're going to dog the puck. We're going to dog the puck quickly and pursue it throughout the night. And right now it's Joel Ward doing just that. It's Higgins through center in close quarters with Bonino. Stick check by Joel Ward, a two-goal performance last night, helping to pave the way for Washington. Burrows will swing. Oof. Good intercept there by Schmidt. Latta saucers down the wing for Chimera, wide of the goal, guarded by Ryan Miller, who has tasted just two shots from the Caps so far.
And both them long range, easy saves routine right into his catching glove.
Fay with a ripoff, leaves for Hansen. Back to Fay. Great save by Peters. Down low, deflection try goes wide. Hansen looked like he had a layup there.
He did. Capitals careless with the puck so far here in the first in their own zone. Fortunately for them, they have Peters holding down the fort.
Play brought to a halt thanks to a hand pass. The Capitals can thank Justin Peters. Razor sharp in the first 10 minutes of the game. Here, he robs Bay at point blank range on Comcast Sportsnet. No score in this one. Star Trek's presented by Toyota. European imports locker that can travel at high speed.
For the Caps, they call him Cozy. Kuznetsov playing a lot better. 24th game tonight, 12 points so far. On the other side, you got to look at
my head.
Radim Vrbata, 800 career game tonight, already 8 points this season. He's a sniper. He's had 20 goals last year and 51 points. And the one thing about Vrbata, when he plays with the Sedin, Joe, he pulls the trigger. Fifth most shots right now in the NHL.
Radim Vrbata started the season with goals in 4 of the first 5 Vancouver games. That first line has been hot. These Canucks off to a 4-3 start. Playing out of the Pacific Division, Washington at 4-1-2. From the Metropolitan.
Yeah, the Caps just not clean in their own zone. Just not making good decisions.
Deflection try stopped there by Peters. Another dandy. Vancouver, it appears, it's just a matter of time.
Now, the big thing on the road, guys, you've just got to make sure you get through that first period. If you can weather the storm in the first 10 and even be, you know, knotted up at zeros at the end of the first period, it's going to be in the Caps' favor. Give them time to get their game on.
Odd man rush, Johansson closing. Ham Hughes stopped that. And then Miller vacuums up the rebound from Brouwer.
Yeah, fabulous defensive play there on that 3-on-1 turned into a 2-on-1. The Caps in their own zone having trouble. Here they just throw it to the net, looking for a little redirect and a couple of whacks at it. And Peters scrambling all this first period. They put a lot of rubber towards his way. Obviously, their game plan is get pucks to the net. Peters has withstood the storm so far.
Alex Edler accelerates out of his own zone for Daniel Sedin, then on for Radim Vrbata. The dish to the slot. Peters makes the stop there on the Canuck captain, Henrik Sedin. Henrik didn't get a lot of wood on that. Nicholas Backstrom checking his rear view mirror, sends it on around as Alsner activates. Eric Fair drags it below the goal line. Tanev will pounce on it. Niskanen jumps in from the other point. Further example of 5 guys in the offensive zone. Daniel Sedin, a smart looking entry for Tanev. Rolls it on around to Henrik Sedin. Then Daniel, covered up by Backstrom. Henrik Sedin measured along the boards. And Niskanen will be able to play clear. Icing is washed out. Barry Trotz will make a line change as we leak below 8 minutes to go in the opening stanza. Ward distributes for Latta. And then Liam O'Brien. Weber putting up a fuss there. Burrows looking for some space. Staying strong on his stick for Higgins, who glanced it on. The long wrister from Weber. No worries for Justin Peters. He'll hold. 7:31 left. Opening period of play. Capitals still north of the border on Comcast.
I think, again, we're trying to improve every night, trying to get better. We were not happy with how our trip started, and I really liked our response. Like I said, it was led by Brooks Orpik and his physical presence last game, and tonight we'll need some other guys to step up. It's a six-man unit back there with our defensive crew, and I'm confident in all of them, and everyone's a hero on any given night, so looking forward to a good challenge.
Our legal seafoods bite of the night, assistant coach Todd Reardon, who presides over the Capitals defense. Caps have been doing a lot of defending in this first period, being outshot 12-3 unofficially with 7:25 to go in the first.
You know, one of the things we see with the Vancouver Canucks, and they're a team that even when they lose the faceoff, they gain possession. It's because they don't back out of the zone. They continue to pursue the puck, and they create all types of scoring chances, turnovers, all types of odd situations for themselves by not leaving the zone. And that's one of the things that Bruce Boudreau, when you watch the Anaheim Ducks, is something his team has done. And I see that now in the Capitals. When they're not winning the draw in the other team's zone, they're applying pressure rather than backing off and letting odd man rushes come towards themselves.
Look at Miller's numbers versus the Caps, 15-12-0, 2.5, 9-1-7, 3 shutouts, closing in on 300 wins.
With as many fits as he has given the Capitals, you'd think his record would be better than that.
Yeah.
In the last few years with a Buffalo team that's been downtrodden, Ovechkin works in, poke check there. So many of those games, Miller was just keeping the Sabres alive. Backstrom plays it out wide. Carlson's on the run through center. And this is offside against Washington on the entry.
The big boys on the ice out there. They've matched up most of this hockey game. Ovechkin's line against the Twins, Sedin and Verbata.
Locker and Allen, what's your theory about first line against first line?
I like it. I like the challenge, putting up your best players against the opposition's best players. Allen?
Well, I'm with you there too, Locker. You know what? You've got to get your best players on the ice, and in key situations, the best players need to be on the ice. So, absolutely, if you let the other team dictate how you play your game, your first line's never going to get on the ice. And I played for some guys that ruined our game on the road by letting the other team decide who they were going to put out there. So you just put your best player out there and let them match with who they want.
And that's when someone like Nicklas Backstrom becomes all the more valuable with his defensive responsibilities. Folks, the 2015 Bridgestone NHL Winter Classic is going to be played on January 1st, 2015 in Nationals Park. For more information on how to guarantee access to tickets, call 202-266-CAPS or you can visit WashingtonCaps.com.
When you think about it, Craig, you know, you look at the best players on the teams. The Sedins are two of the most exciting players in the National Hockey League. Alexander Ovechkin, Nicklas Backstrom, two of the most exciting players. I could watch these guys play all game long and don't really care so much about the other guys as a fan. From a fan perspective, you just want to see those guys get it going all night long. Not a jab at anyone, but really, those guys are incredibly exciting.
People love watching you.
Well, they liked when we dropped the gloves and finished our hits, but they were there to watch. They paid to watch the other guys.
I know.
Like you.
Yeah,
the big
right. No, I'm not involved.
You and Greg Adam.
Yeah. He's here tonight, by the way.
I saw him. I couldn't miss that head anywhere.
Wow, that's two shots.
I haven't seen him yet. He's supposed to drop by.
How could you not see him?
Brad Richardson on the go. We are in Vancouver. The end of a three-game road swing for Washington as Latta propels through center. Hamhuis took away his skating lane, and Bieksa has the puck. 5.5 to go. Along with Craig Lachlan and Alan May, I'm Joe Beninati. As we shout out thanks to all the men and women in our technical crew for their efforts, it's the NHL on CSN. Good keep by Hamhuis. Fires one wide of Justin Peters, who's been tested regularly in this first period. No score with Vancouver tripling up the Caps in terms of shots. Bieksa will explore center ice. Good moves on the hand-to-head for Burrows. Alsner's waiting. On around for Eric Fair. Indirectly to Backstrom. Shortens up on his hockey stick. And delivers the backhand to Ryan Miller. 4:48 with which to work in this opening period. Edler out wide for Burrows. Sneaking into the zone. Burrows pulls the trigger. Had that blocked by Orpik. John Carlson. On for Beagle, crunched there by Edler. Chris Tanev to a turning Edler. The head man for Verbata. To the front, Daniel Sedin off the outside of the goal.
I don't think he realized he had a lot more time to collect that pass off the wing on the center drive. Instead, he just redirected it. Had Sedin kept control, he had a chance for a quick deep in the high slot.
Evgeny Kuznetsov to the front, looking for Beagle. It came on through. Kuznetsov faced Vancouver last year at Verizon Center, put up a 3-assist game, first 3 points of his NHL career. Henrik Sedin for Verbata, then Daniel below the goal line. Saucers one to the front. collected by Chimera.
Capitals can't let that happen. That's where that trio is most effective, below the dots and behind the net. They cause a lot of problems. You got to quickly get them away from the net and up the boards.
Offside against Washington. Away we go to commercial break. Back for the conclusion of the opening period in a moment. Opportunity looking at all four. Joel Ward tallies.
Deflection there and a Carlson shot. He gets a lucky bounce off the backboards and off the left foot of the New Jersey netminder last night. Gets a nice grip off the defenseman Eglin for his third, his fourth. A thing of beauty, just hard work in the paint to jam it home. 82 career goals for Joel Ward, 57 even, 19 PPGs, and six shorties for Joel.
He will always remember this building fondly. Played his first NHL game here as a member of the Minnesota Wild back in 2006. Ryan Miller in his first season with the Canucks this year, playing goal tonight in a nothing-nothing draw.
Yeah, lots of changes in Vancouver after not making the playoffs. The locals very restless, and it started at the top with Trevor Linden shaking up the whole franchise.
Ryan, of course, will remember this building and this city fondly for his Olympic performance as Alsner blasts this one off a defender. Burakovsky on the delay. Johansson shimmies to the front, lost the handle, as Hansen will just plop it back to center. Dorsett badgering Alsner to the boards. 3 minutes away from Lattice's intermission line. Alsner through center, content to dump it in. Bench is begging for the line change. Hamhuis. Steady as she goes, blue liner on a control breakout now. The clear ahead for Cassian. Caroms off of his skates to the turning Nicholas Backstrom. Backstrom delivers for Orpik. Carlson knifing into the offensive zone, not going far. Face full of Sean Matthias. Caps fans remember him from his days with Florida. Carlson looks up and open Eric Fair. Using the glass to get it deep. Bieksa rumbling there back behind the net. Ovechkin's centering pass did not get through. 2:05 to play. Bonino dumped it in, but he did so from behind the center line, so that's icing against Vancouver. Folks, we want you involved, even this late at night on the weekend, on Twitter, hashtag Capitals Talk. Who's the best player in the Western Conference? Let the arguments begin. Who is the best of the best in the West?
I'll go over my list later. How about that?
You have a list?
I have a list of guys.
A list?
A list of six or seven guys that are included in my top players.
Well, I guess we can give a list.
Duchesne.
Oh, he's nice.
He's not the best player.
O'Brien fires. It's a
Doughty.
Good save. You still haven't gotten the best player yet.
Kane.
No.
Taves.
Thank you. The best player in the West. Green.
That's debatable. I'm starting a team,
that's
I'm
why you have
Doughty.
A list.
Yeah, I'm taking Doughty.
That's why you have a list.
Are we playing Chicago soon? Maybe I'll take Jonathan.
It's a good start. 1:24 to go. Clear ahead off of Higgins. Bonino drives that one wide. Latta scoops it off the boards and out. Get the whistle here. The draw's going to come back in the Washington zone.
Yeah, right off the bench there. And so the puck comes, faceoff comes where that puck was shot from for Beagle and the boys. Another line change. Puck 12 left. 14-6 are the shots against OV's club. OV's had two or three heavy hits so far here in the first. Caps want to make sure on this faceoff, sending out Backstrom in an extra center here.
Alex Ovechkin, in the overlap of his career with Ryan Miller, has had success against the All-Star and Vezina Trophy winner. Good goal-scoring success. Nobody's on the board just yet. Approaching the final minute of period one. Johansson takes it to safety and sends in. Brower will put a flame on Tanev, who lost his footing. Brower to the front, swinging a miss for Johansson. Snared by Burakovsky. That sharp wrister deflected by another Swede, Daniel Sedin. Verbata fidgets loose. Henrik Sedin closing. There's Daniel. There's that sixth sense. They always know where the other is.
And if the ice is smooth at the start of a period, they probably execute that a lot better than the bouncing biscuit we just saw on the scene.
25 seconds separating us from Lattice's intermission live. Matt Niskanen in control for Washington. Drags it on around for Carl Alsner. Niskanen looks up. Fair pinch by Hamhuis. Hansen to the deep slot. There's Ovechkin. 6 seconds to work. Ovechkin tries to get to the inside. Mieksa says, no, you don't. Fair with a backhand as the period comes to its conclusion.
And in the locker room for the Caps are going to be saying, okay, boys, we didn't play our best period overall, but we're still in it. There's no score. Peters held us in on the Vancouver side. Maybe a little frustration not being able to score early. Vancouver by far the better team in the first 20 minutes.
As the two sides cool off, we make our way to Lattice's intermission live. Alan May will have a guest with him shortly. Highlights and stats too. And with our anniversary retrospective, we'll choose another great scoring Swede, Bent Akke.
Ah, Bent Gustafsson, love him.
Bent Akke. Justin Peters was fabulous. No score after 20. Back to the studio to get things started with Al Kokin and Brent Johnson. Our Comcast Sportsnet coverage of Capitals hockey tonight being brought to you by your Washington area Honda dealers. Morgan Franklin Consulting. Big capabilities, local roots. MorganFranklin.com. Land Rover. Visit DCAreaLandRover.com for attractive offers. And by Crop Metcalf. For all your plumbing needs, call Crop Metcalf, home of the five-star technician. This is only the third home game of the season for the Vancouver Canucks as they entertain the Washington Capitals. We are through 20 minutes inside of Rogers Arena with no score. Joe Beninati, Craig Lachlan, Alan May inside the glass with you tonight. 40th anniversary for the Caps, and we shed light on Bent Gustafsson.
Yeah, I was fortunate to play with this slick Swede, number 16, was a big part of the power play. Could kill penalties. He was a do-it-all type player. Racked up big offensive numbers. I like that one, Joby, using Christian as a decoy and said, you know what, I'm going to call my own number. He had such a slick shot. His stick hardly had any tape on it ever, and he was able to stick handle like unbelievably out of a phone booth. He was that good with the puck.
Bent Gustafsson selected 55th overall in the 78 draft, but look at the numbers that he produced.
33 game winners. You see all those shorties, close to 200 goals, 555 points, 5 goals at the Flyers. I remember that. Bonder tied that in 94. He did have the record for rookie points at one point until the grade 8 showed up. He had 60 points, and a lot of people don't know just how great a coach Bent is. In fact, he's the only coach in history, I think, who won in 06, both the Olympic gold and the world championship gold in the same year.
Nicholas Backstrom has played for him. With respect to the national team, Burakovsky, before his time is through, you could imagine will be on a Swedish national team. Set play off the draw. Fair rolls in. Stopped by Ryan Miller.
And they tried that last night, the exact same play, if you remember, against Calgary, and they had a quality chance. Same set play right off the faceoff. Nicely executed.
That's a huge save for Ryan Miller. I thought the goalies were pretty interesting in the Gustafsson video. We saw him score on Fuhr, Hang, and Hanlon.
There you go, right off the faceoff, and it's a set play where Fair holds up and then gets away from his winger and curls to the middle. Nicely done. Just an excellent stop by Miller.
John Carlson made the pass to spring him.
Did he go top shelf on Panger?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry.
He didn't have to.
Okay.
Opening minute of the second period. Daniel Sedin on the puck to twin brother Henrik. Point position Tanev. Switch it up for Edler. Wrister on the way. Glove down by Justin Peters. Daniel Sedin leaves it back behind the cage. Verbata waved at by Carlson. They place it back behind for Daniel to Henrik once more. Flooding this side, now it's Verbata. Forced to the perimeter by Backstrom. 5-on-5 play as Orpik muscles up on Henrik Sedin. The officials allowing the play to continue. Vancouver fans wanted a call there.
They wanted a call for Brooks Orpik being too strong on that one. And after last night, you have to be very wary if you're the Vancouver Canucks if you pre-scouted that game after those 10 big hits that he had.
There were a few KOs in that game from Orpik Allen. It was his fourth career 10-hit game. Ham Hughes with Burakovsky drawing a bead on him. Brower lost it to Ham Hughes on the outlet to Richardson. Drifting wide, Niskanen takes care of him. Brower pins Mathias to the backboards. Ham Hughes to a shooting lane. Alsner for Washington shuffles it ahead, but Bieksa had pinched way in from the point. Taking a page from the Capitals book there. Look out. Ham Hughes, a pair of twos to the corner. To the slot for Cassian, poke check the side by Alsner. And this is Johansson one-on-one with Bieksa. Marcus Johansson's drive stopped by the pad of Ryan Miller. Left a pretty tasty rebound. There was no cap there. Yevgeny Kuznetsov on the reload. It's Schmidt will scamper in. His centering pass didn't have enough starch on it. Mike Green scoops it to the gloved hand of Bieksa. We're 2.5 minutes old in period two. Schmidt with Bay drawing a bead on him. Right into the waiting Dorsett. Beagle chops it ahead. Yannick Weber on target for the entry. There's Hansen on the drop for Bay. This fourth line for Vancouver was sharp in the first. Swing and a miss there from Spezza. It's trouble. Chimera goes the other way. Jason Chimera pulls up for Beagle, who was undercut. Capitals bench wanting a trip. None from the referees tonight, Walsh and Watson.
Real good back check by Bay for the Vancouver Canucks. The Caps had a 2-on-1 from the blue line on in, but Bay caught up, making it a 1-on-1, really denying a good scoring chance for the Caps.
Delayed offside, washed against Vancouver. Orpik connecting with Latta. Elevates to Ward for a drive off the pad of Ryan Miller. Latta isolates behind the cage. Gets it topside for Orpik. Ward latched onto there by Bonino and by Burrows. And Tanev will try the other flank. Lucas Spezza was a -5 in Denver last time out on Friday.
Man, he thought he might be a healthy scratch when he came to the rink this morning, but not the case. One of their big defensemen, Stanton, who will definitely help out, is still injured and unable to play.
He was skating with the Canucks earlier today. The Caps did not have a morning skate after traveling in from Calgary.
And with a 6:30 skate, pregame skate for Vancouver was at 9:30 after a day off completely yesterday after their pregame road trip.
Henrik Sedin sends it out wide. Bieksa mauled there by Backstrom and vice versa. Matt Niskanen will give some ground. No score in this contest. Just about 25 minutes old. As Niskanen plays that soft little reverse for Alsner. Verbata wouldn't let the Caps out of their own end. Henrik Sedin to the front. And backtracking was Backstrom in good shape. Ovechkin's pass for Alsner, offside against Washington, washed out. Richardson butting into Alsner. Daniel Sedin, an area pass for Verbata. The Sedins love to throw the puck into space. It's a lot like a good quarterback throwing the ball when the receiver isn't even there yet. Cassian bullying his way down the dasher. The hip check coming from Niskanen that was ready. Ovechkin on the go. Alex Ovechkin snapshot, snared by Miller, and he'll cover. On the Toyota League leaderboard locker, it's the best of the blue line boppers so far.
Yeah, you look around the league, guys that throwing around their body around, and you're going to see Orpik right up there. Polak, Weber, Orpik, Regier, Heda are all right up there over 25 or more, and Orpik not too far off the pace of the Toronto defenseman who they got from St. Louis.
See Brooks Orpik with that shiner under the right eye. Compliments of a Brandon Bolig left cross. Green scales this one. It's gloved by Burakovsky. Nice setup. Score! Marcus Johansson.
You can't say enough about Marcus Johansson right now. The way he's really adapted to playing with Burakovsky, accepting the speed and making sure that his stick is always available, not passing up his opportunities to shoot his puck, and really using his wheels. You know, it's nice about this power play. Caps continue to move the puck around, get it to stick, and make sure. But look at the patience of the kid, and wow, puts it right on a stick. Makes no doubt about it. Marcus Johansson just fires that in the back of the net.
Yeah, great settle of the puck by Burakovsky. After he catches that one off the defender, lays it down, and that pass has to be right on the mark, and it is for Marcus to take one lateral move, which pulls the goaltender off the goal line and opens up a spot for the shot. Caps needed that goal. Now let's see what happens. Let's see if they get their feet moving and move forward here as Marcus has his third of the season.
All three of those goals this year in the second period, and Johansson in his brief career overlapping with Vancouver, nice numbers there. Just the fifth game he has seen them, but he has struck three times against the Canucks, much to Barry Trotz's liking.
And Burakovsky, Joe, another 5-on-5 plus, so he now leads the team who was leading anyways. Now he's plus six, tops among all Caps players.
A Schmidt drive that goes wide. Joel Ward spins it back on top for Mike Green. Marcus Johansson's third goal of the campaign, giving the Caps the advantage just a few moments ago. As we have the penalty call coming up.
That's a cheapie, too. Ladd is complaining. It's going to be a little hook from behind, I think, and it's going to be Ladd heading off. Caps aren't going to like this call. They've let everything go so far, but Ladd is going to have a seat, and there's the referee talking.
White hooking.
And there's the hooking call, and it started when the puck squirted free above the circle, Joe, and Ladd is trying to back check. Here it is. Watch it squirt free right there to the defender. Watch the stick right there. Man, not too much to pull him down.
Close to the hands,
yeah.
Though. Close to the hands. Get that stick in there, and the referees are going to be looking for it. Vancouver's power play is ranked 18th on the circuit.
Get that stick in there and then fall. You're good to go, I guess.
Washington's penalty kill at 84% now. The Capitals have surrendered a power play goal in their last three outings as Beagle cruises down the flank. Beagle and Brouwer, Orpik and Carlson to penalty kill in white for Washington.
And one guy you don't have to worry about is Jason Garrison. He used to have a bomb from the point. So now they like to move it around a lot. They're a passing power play, Joe, more than a shooting one.
Alan May referred to it as an elephant gun.
Yeah.
Well, you got to have one of those in every power play. You've got to have guys that are dangerous and a threat to shoot the puck, because the formations of the penalty killers will overplay that player and opening up the other players to make those quick 4-on-3 plays.
Bonino on a slap pass looking for the redirect from Higgins as Beagle will send it on down. The penalty killers can change. Trust me, Alex Edler can shoot a puck quite well. 23 in blue. He's out there now taking the handoff from Hamhuis. Gliding through center to the trailer, Henrik Sedin. Washington shorthanded another 48 ticks. Towards the cage, Justin Peters, who was magnificent in the first, allowing the Caps to stay alive in this game, a game in which they now have the lead. They'll get Latta back in a half a minute as Edler turns and leans into this rush on for Vey, who had a great chance to score in the first. Surrounded there by two defenders, Alzer makes the rip-off but didn't get it out. Edler walks the line. Henrik Sedin closes. The feed to the front looking for Daniel came on through. Verbata hooks. Vey down low. Flushed out by Niskanen. Edler switched the point of attack. Backdoor swing and a miss from Vey, and now Backstrom can go with Fair. This is a potential 3-on-1. Backstrom closing. Fires. Missed it on the short side. Caps back to even strength. Latta will place it in deep and then check out for the line change. Henrik Sedin on the long clear ahead. It explodes off of Matthias. Niskanen trundles it along for Brouwer. He'll team up with Ovechkin through center. Green working wide to the front. Kuznetsov bats that wide of the goal. Alex Ovechkin tied up with Richardson. Back come the Canucks in the homestanding blue jerseys. Mathias on a chip and chase. Heavy hitting back behind the cage, guarded by Justin Peters. Through center, a pass intended for Brouwer never arrived. Peters at one end, Miller the other. Ryan backed up by Eddie Lack. Braden Holtby sits second chair to Peters tonight. Here's Ward behind the D. Joel Ward, snapshot, head save, and cat quick. Ryan Miller makes the cover up. 8 minutes and 59 seconds into period two. Washington badly outshot in the first. They've picked up their game. They've ramped up offensively. And Johansson has hit pay dirt on CSN. Here they come, the hard hits highlights of the game brought to you by Timberland Pro.
Boys and whites following the road led by that guy, the captain, Alex Ovechkin. Everybody getting involved. Michael Latta down low, Brouwer getting some hits. Good hit by O'Brien, another one by Fair. Pretty heavy hitting up there. The Caps have been physical, especially on the forecheck.
Play resumes in the neutral zone. Joel Ward out there, teaming up with Burakovsky and Chimera this trip. Jason Chimera roughhousing with Burrows. Niskanen had that one carom away. It'll be collected by Carl Alsner on the Washington side of center. Chimera steers one in. Burakovsky, who's picked up another assist tonight. A sweet feed for Marcus Johansson to stash past Ryan Miller. It's 1-0 Caps. Alsner, wrister on the way, wide of a screen, Miller. The Capitals badly outshooting the Canucks in this frame. At one point, it was 8-1. Higgins scooped that one off the linesman, Knorr, as Peters will tee it up. Coach Desjardins will change on the go for Vancouver. Caps getting their signals crossed in front of their own bench. And Dorsett will rewind. Tanev takes the feed from Edler and motors through center. Edler gets the center stripe right to the goalie stick of Justin Peters. Orpik sends it hard around. It got through Edler back onto the Vancouver side. On the send in, Backstrom leaves it. Ovechkin's head fakes to the front for Fair. He golfed at it as he was tangled up with Tanev. Dorsett speeding after this one. And taking Carlson heavily to the boards. In that hybrid icing, that was one in which the linesman felt the race was going to be won by the forward. And as a result, those are the kinds of collisions you're looking to avoid.
I thought Ty was supposed to go to the D on that one, on the defending team in that situation, because that really was a bad situation. And that's everything they're trying to avoid with that rule change, and the league got off very lucky in that situation that neither of those players were injured.
Good call by you. That's Alan May inside the glass. It's a two-on-one. Henrik Sedin's pass, great play made defensively by Nate Schmidt.
And he usually doesn't miss that pass. You have to be a real smart defender to take that one away. He's trying to put it between your body and the blade of your stick and sort of that little triangle, and that's where it's hard to defend. Nate Schmidt, what a play against arguably their best player.
And that's all part of the Caps holding their blue line, having the confidence. I know that was back off the blue line, but rather than backing off, staying in that lane, know exactly where to be every game. The coaches are consistent with how they're supposed to play in these situations.
That was a ripoff of a former NHL MVP. A guy who has had a couple of 70 assist seasons in his career. Well done, Nate Schmidt. Bieksa joins the rush, drops it to Higgins. Higgins to the goal mouth, deflection, Peters the save. He made another pad stop on Bonino. Justin Peters is putting on a clinic tonight. Edler staving off Jay Beagle. Higgins is there to support, four in the scrum. Canucks blazing a path back through center. Bieksa likes to get up into the flow. He'll drop this one towards the cage wide of Justin Peters, who made another two good stops there. Liam O'Brien on ice with Latta and Beagle now. Joel Ward has been bumped up a line. As Edler cruises in, drops for Mathias. Wide open, sprawling save by Peters. Fabulous on Cassian.
Now some pushing and shoving. O'Brien right in the thick of things. Guys being hauled down by the linesman. Lots of pushing and shoving. A little frustration with their inability to beat the Capitals netminder.
Justin Peters was fabulous when this was a scoreless game. He's been even better now that they have the lead. The Caps do. Capitals have a 1-0 advantage over the Vancouver Canucks. Scary moment a few moments ago for John Carlson.
And it's the hybrid icing, and there's the linesman right at the imaginary line. Dean Dorsett was ahead of Carlson, was going to get to the puck first. Heavy collision at the other end. Pretty good passing play, Higgins to Bieksa. Then another follow-up by Bonino. All over the Capitals' paint, but their inability to score works out nicely for Justin Peters. He's been spectacular.
And then just before we were going to break, he robbed Zach Cassian to keep this a 1-0 advantage. Justin Peters, 28-year-old Ontario native.
Pete Dog, right?
The Pete Dog.
That's his nickname?
Yes, it is.
Oh, beautiful. You should have seen him working out before the game, guys. You'd both be in the hospital for a couple days. He really gets ready, does a great job.
Don't take you off the list.
Hospital, no. Traction, yes. Traction at home, preferred. 6:55 with which to work in the middle period. Capitals finishing up a road swing through Western Canada. They'll stay in Vancouver overnight, make their way back to the D.C. area tomorrow. They'll entertain Detroit on Wednesday. Is Fair onside? No. The deflected puck through the timing of the play off.
Man, both teams, a lot of offsides in this hockey game because Alan and I have been talking a lot about, you know, the way they stand up, and both teams do. And you'll see the little redirect right off the defenseman's skate. And see Fair just one stride over the blue line. The puck must cross completely over the blue line before the player does. And that's a pretty good call right at the blue line.
Barry Trotz always barking orders on that player's bench for Washington. The Capitals have a 1-0 advantage. Marcus Johansson at the 5:28 mark. Burakovsky on the primary assist. Bonino on the drop. Hamhuis towards the goal. That's an easy stop for Justin Peters.
Right into the belly and absolutely nothing coming off it. Hamhuis used to play for Barry Trotz for many seasons in Nashville, and when he was asked about the Capitals team, he says, well, it's taken the identity of the head coach. And they're a hardworking team. They play defense, all the things that he had under Barry Trotz when he was part of the Predators.
Hamhuis is fifth full season here in Vancouver, 8 with Nashville. Right off the draw, there's an interference call to come.
And it's going against the Caps' Carl Alsner right off the draw. And so the second penalty kill has to come up large for the Caps. Alsner off the draw to the right. Take a look at the right side of the screen. There's a little interference that allows Niskanen to pick up the puck, and he gives it to what for. And that's a good play by Richardson, drawing the penalty. The Caps go to the PK.
Carl Alsner, a little camera shy there. Verbata, Henrik Sedin, Daniel Sedin, Lyndon Vay, and Alex Edler, 5 on ice in blue. Henrik Sedin sets up shop on the rotation for Daniel. Daniel to Henrik, inside, stopped there by Peters. Ricochet comes bouncing wide, follow-up chance, they score! Henrik Sedin.
Unlucky bounce for the Caps. They had it off the faceoff. So look at them win the draw right there, and the Caps don't get it out. They had it on their stick. Did John Carlson hits a man. Now they keep it alive. Now you're in trouble when you don't make the initial clear. They go down low. Does it take more than one chance? It takes two, three. Finally, just hits the glove. And they get lucky on this because from up here, it looked like Peters in really good position to nab that Henrik Sedin shot right off his glove. They've tied it up here on the power play.
That last replay angle, a thing of beauty. Goal line extended for Henrik Sedin and banking it in off of Justin Peters, who almost made that stop just the same. 14-minute mark of the second period. We are level at 1. The Capitals now have surrendered a power play goal in 4 straight outings. Daniel Sedin skips it towards the cage, and Justin will take no chances. As we step out to commercial break with 5:34 to go in period number 2. Henrik Sedin, normally the feeder, There he provides with a shot on CSN. These are your Sport Fans of the Game, brought to you by Sport Automotive Chevrolet and Honda via Sport Fan 2. Visit sportautomotive.com. Flecks of red, white, and blue throughout the crowd here in Vancouver. Inside of Rogers Arena, the sellout streak ended for the first time since 2002 last week, Locker, in these parts.
That's amazing. You're not happy, Joe B. Get disgruntled when you don't make the playoffs in Canada.
So Vancouver team, all they did was win the Northwest Division 5 years in a row before missing the playoffs last year.
Well, that wasn't very fun hockey to watch here last year. They totally took away what they were great at, and it was always playing a high-speed game, puck possession, the Sedins out there dishing and doing all that stuff they do down low in the cycle like no one else in the league. And all of a sudden, they were backing off, playing slow in the neutral zone, just getting rid of the puck with those 160-foot passes and the long chip. And, man, this is so much better to watch what they've been doing this season early under their new coach, Willie Desjardins.
Who was a Calder Cup winner most recently in the American Hockey League with the Texas Stars. The Ward drop pass was vacuumed up and played clear by Cassian as we drift below 5 minutes to go in period two.
You know, Joe, Willie's actually a guy that's won at every single level that he's coached. Canadian college hockey.
Bonino fires to the top corner.
Looked like a little bit of a line change up here, and then the Canucks sprung themselves on a two-on-one, and Bonino far side over the glove, and Barry Trotz is looking on and saying, hey, what just happened here? Look at the line change there. Little bit of confusion as they were coming off, then a quick up, chip to the middle, a finish of a check, and then he was way too in tight, wasn't pressured. Right here, Alzner's backing in, and there comes that shot. They got Bonino from the Ducks, and he rips it home. They were hoping he could collect a lot of the minutes that Kessler did, and there he makes the Caps pay in the neutral zone with his speed.
Two tallies separated by 122. And quickly, the game's complexion changes. It's 2-1 now for the Canucks in the blue jerseys. Bonino's pass to the front looking for Burrows. Spezza fires and scores! Luca Spezza from long range.
Well, Barry Trotz is fuming on the Caps bench, as he should be. You don't want goals in bunches. That Spezza blast is 25 seconds after the Bonino snapshot. Here they are. They don't clear the puck. They don't get it out. Hard shot, and that baby had eyes. Right past everybody in white. Here it is. Look at Alzner has it. Clips it too far ahead of himself. No one gets to it. And Spezza, which we've been talking about, Alan May down low, both teams really holding the line. A lot of time the defense would be backing up. Spezza held the line, stayed inside the blue, and pounded it top corner.
24-year-old Lucas Spezza, acquired from Anaheim in the Ryan Kessler deal. John Carlson jumping up into the rush in the blink of an eye, a blink of an eye that's less than 2 minutes. The Canucks have 3 goals on the board and a healthy lead. As Carlson outlasts Daniel Sedin, this is icing against Vancouver.
Yeah, Vancouver turning up the pace, turning up the speed. A little chaos in the neutral zone cost the Caps in that quick up chip to the middle. 2-on-1. Desjardins' team getting a couple of odd man breaks here as he's got his clipboard waiting to diagram any type of plays. He's got to be pretty happy with the way his club has responded.
And he's got his guys doing a great job of funneling the Caps off to the boards, and they've got excellent back pressure now, so they're taking away that any opportunity for the winger to get the puck to the front of net. So the Caps are going to have to find a way to get that puck up center ice, get over the blue line, and then dish it to the side, get quick shots with traffic.
John Carlson able to keep this one in. 3.5 minutes to go, second period. Carlson to the heart of the defense. Met there by several Canucks, namely Chris Tanev, who played clear.
That power play may work to their advantage, too. They haven't had an extra man yet.
Vancouver has had a couple. Mike Green ladles it on for Latta. The chip for Backstrom goes awry. At the attacking line, Vancouver whistled offside.
things have unraveled quickly. You know, the Caps were taking it to them for the first 10 minutes. Things have changed drastically with the three goals and a buck 47. And then it's all started on a clear attempt that stayed in, which allowed Henrik to score. And they got some mo on their power play against the Caps.
Washington, only three wins technically in its last 10 visits here. And as we've mentioned in the opening period, no wins in these parts since 2001. Sounds worse than it really is. They don't come here that often. Two teams will see each other in early December at Verizon Center. For the moment, it's a 3-1 lead. Deflection, score! The first NHL goal for Liam O'Brien.
That's a huge one. What a response there. They throw out the so-called fourth line and they deliver. And the top guns maybe aren't getting the chances because of matchups. The fourth liners do. O'Brien's got a keepsake to put on the mantle back home in Eastern Canada. First goal of his NHL career, and it's a top shelfer against Miller on a beautiful redirection. High fives all around, taps on the back. Here it is, hard shot. Look at where O'Brien is. You see Miller down prematurely, and up and over it goes. O'Brien on the board, giving Caps life.
And that's exactly where he's got to be. You've got to get players and bodies to the front of that stick on the ice, ready to battle, and it worked out perfectly for him there. And great wall work once again. You talked about that last night, Craig. The key to being successful on the road is being great on the wall, and that's what the Capitals did on that goal.
17-18, the time of the tally for O'Brien. Liam's first NHL point came on an assist. A Mike Green goal against San Jose. His first NHL marker authored against Ryan Miller. Not half bad. Orpik will swing. It's back to a one-goal deficit for Washington. Joel Ward will clear in. Weber reversing. Spins it on for Cassian. Just squirts back to center. Marcus Johansson there. He gave the Caps the advantage in period two. We had no score through 20. Five goals on the board in the middle frame. And perhaps more here as Brouwer works deep. Burakovsky angled by Higgins. Whistle and a penalty call. It's going to be a hold. Holding the preliminary indication.
And maybe against the Caps as he grabbed the shoulder. So here comes their third power play. Burakovsky's going to go off. And he's saying, what for? From up here, he grabbed the shoulder and gave a little tug, but sort of another cheapie. Here it is. You see Brouwer being taken out down low. Watch Burakovsky. Right there, that left hand just on the shoulder of the defenseman, Tanev. And the referee, oh, too fine of a call there. Late in the period, Burakovsky off to the box.
Well, now they're going to have to worry about killing this penalty. And the thing that Canucks did different on that last power play is they got the puck to the net quick. And four players converge down into that area below the hash marks. And you're going to see it again, where the Sedins rotate, they come around, pass the puck down, look for that quick shot. When they stay in the perimeter, that's exactly what you want.
Henrik Sedin drags it to the corner. Back behind the cage, interchanging with Verbata. Canuck captain pounded to the corner by Orpik. 1:13 left in the period. Caps will be shorthanded for the balance if they can keep Vancouver off the board as Brouwer sends it all the way down. Miller looks up, the turning stick of the Swedish-born Edler, driving back through neutral. Henrik Sedin fumbled it, right onto the blade of Daniel.
Doesn't it work out well for the good players?
That's what happens. On the interchange, Verbata off the cycle. Playing the two-man game with Vey. Swivels on Niskanen. Henrik Sedin with 38 seconds to operate. Daniel gets involved. Pinned to the boards by Alsner. Pokes the puck loose, nice job, and Chimera goes 2-on-2 the other way with Ward. Ward is the trailer. Skipping to the interior, he lost the handle. 20 seconds left in the frame. Daniel Sedin on the drop. Bonino to the front, right on in, and Edler gunned it wide. Great chance for Alex Edler. Look out, a lot of Canucks there on the ice. That could be too many men.
Got to be a too many men, and yeah. I believe it is, exactly.
They had six guys there on a line change. The one defenseman, when he threw it over, did not realize that Edler was changing on the play. And that cost them mightily.
Vancouver, bench Meyer, too many men.
And you could hear the Capitals bench all the way up here yelling for too many men. Cam Hughes wants an explanation, not going to get it. Here you'll take a look, three guys on one side. On the left side, you'll see all the line change. Three, four, five, six. Guys, that is the correct call. Just about seven with one guy hanging over the boards.
So when we get into that third period, the Caps are going to have a power play for about a minute and 20. For the meantime, with 10 seconds left in this period, it's 4-on-4. Backstrom repositioning Ovechkin. Digging in against Richardson on this draw. Richardson only won 2 of 12 against Colorado Friday. Backstrom kicked out. Ovechkin beaten by Richardson. Second period about to come to its conclusion, and it was a wild one. Plenty of red lights through two periods. The Canucks have the lead, 3-2.
Good life, though, after that Liam O'Brien goal. Way to go, kid. First NHL goal is always special. Gives the Caps some life. Still 20 minutes to go. Not a bad place to be. Down by one, heading to the third. The Caps need a big push to start the third period.
Plenty of goings on between periods 2 and 3. We like to call it Lattice's Intermission Live. Former Cap Mark Lofthaus is here with us. We'll chit-chat with him. Highlights and stats from tonight. And Locker, of course, to tell us straight. Between periods 2 and 3, it's a one-goal game favor for the Canucks. 3-2 north of the border as we send you to Chris Miles for this Geico Sportsnet Central update. This Comcast Sportsnet coverage of Capitals hockey being brought to you by your Washington area Chevy dealers. Find your local dealer on ChevyFirst.com. 84 Lumber. Get your project started today at 84lumber.com. Toyota. Check out the bold new 2015 Camry and visit buyatoyota.com for offers. And by Knight Point Systems, offering you the technology you need when you need it. Washington Capitals coming to an end of a three-game road swing. Vancouver starting a three-game home stand with this one tonight. The Canucks have a 3-2 lead after two periods of play. Joe Beninati, Craig Laughlin, Alan May inside the glass. Locker, help us understand this graphic. It's about puck possession.
Well, the Capitals attacked the zone and had carry-ins over the blue line 18 of 35 times. The other 17 they dumped in. Once you dumped in, the chance of retrieval are minimal to establish the forecheck. Vancouver, on the other hand, 22 carry-ins, just 10 dump-ins. That means they're controlling the pace, they're controlling the puck. Probably have a much higher Corsi than the Caps have in this hockey game. Both teams want puck possession so far by a slim lead. Vancouver has it.
Henrik Sedin and the Canucks have won their last 5 straight up against Washington in this barn. The Capitals would like to change that tonight. They will be on the power play. Washington will be in 14 seconds. For the moment, we are 4-on-4. Justin Peters has performed valiantly in goal for Washington. The Canucks erupting for 3 goals in a 147 span in the second period. Green works into the offensive zone. Sidesteps Hamhuis and then rockets one wide with Ovechkin joining the play. Alex sees that one go through. Ryan Miller leaves a comfort to the crease. High on the glass and on past Green. Washington's power play on the go now for another 70 seconds. They are third best in the circuit with a 28% conversion. Canucks at 83.9 on the PK. They've allowed a power play goal. The Canucks have in 4 straight games. Tanev with open space able to clear. John Carlson looking up. Brushed it along for Backstrom. Nicklas was drafted in this building back in the summer of 2006. Carlson, Ovechkin fires wide of Miller. And the rebound will chase John Carlson back into his own zone. Bonino will play 4 corners now with the help of Spezza. And Luka drives it all the way down.
My name is Luka.
You knew it had to come.
Oh, I know.
And even, I did it even before midnight back home. Because Netsov zigs and zags out wide. Puts it off the outside of the goal. Good defense there from Yannick Weber. Henrik Sedin stokes it, but not out. Ward cross rink to Burakovsky. 5-on-5 play now, 2 minutes deep in the third. Cassian didn't get it clear. Niskanen with a good keep in. Kuznetsov was draped over his defender there. Burakovsky has no running room afforded him. Spiza digging in defensively. Ward looking back behind the goal. Weber keeps it on the perimeter. Ward with a takeaway. Joel Ward in a one-goal game. He had two last night, paving the way for Washington's win in Calgary. They've won four of their last six visits to Saddledome. Spiza glides through center, plays it on the wing, but Henrik Sedin was not there. Niskanen takes over for the Caps in the white jersey. They're back on home ice on Wednesday. They'll entertain the Detroit Red Wings. It's the first of 12 games that will be carried nationally this season. That one's on NBCSN. Richardson feathers ahead. Chimera will pounce on it. Locker told you at the top of the telecast, game number 800 for Jason tonight. Revolving back through center, Verbata. Leaves it on the wing for Hamhuis. Defended by Green. Chimera, full speed down the flank. Drops it wide of the goal. And it turns out to be an icing call against the Caps. The assist leaders are presented by your local Hyundai dealers. Let them assist you in scoring the lowest prices on the hottest lineup in America.
Active Swedish players, when you look at helpers, Henrik and Daniel at the top, both over 500. Zetterberg, Backstrom, and Louis Eriksson round out our top five Hyundai assist leaders, brought to you about Swedish guys that pass the puck extremely well.
All Swedes who like to share. This is Edler spinning back for Tanev. Chris Tanev gets the center stripe. A backpedaling Mike Green plays it off the boards. Green, who set up Liam O'Brien for the last score on the card, bringing it back to a one-goal game, a one-goal deficit. The ricochet to the slot, Hansen, foiled there by a sliding Michael Latta. Eric Fair sends it on around for Alsner. He's hooked immediately. Dorsett had this one caromed to center. Just shy of the 5 minute mark into period three. Delayed offside against Washington. British Columbian native Carl Alsner sets sail from Burnaby, BC, to be specific. Green just places it back behind Ryan Miller. Miller called upon for only 13 saves. Ovechkin in the front. Backstrom's drive deflected by Bieksa.
Lucky recover there by Bieksa. It's all about stick on puck. That was a beautiful setup and a real bad turnover by the Canucks. The Caps didn't make them pay on that turnover in front of Miller.
Icing against Vancouver. Alan May is inside the glass tonight.
You know, Locker, when you talk about Corsi and offensive zone entries and versus dumping the puck in, when you are forced to dump the puck in, there are certain areas, this area behind the net, inside the area of the net, sending pucks towards the goalie, there are high retrieval rates, but bottom line is you do need to get over the zone. One of the things that the Canucks aren't letting the Capitals do is come through the middle of the ice. They're forcing everything wide, and the Caps are having a tough time getting that puck to the front of the net right now, and the difference in this game will be made as to getting pucks to the front of the net with traffic.
Plenty of traffic along the boards right now, Allen. Higgins jams the puck loose and plays it to center. Johansson stretching his legs. Good shoulder hit from him who's there. Bieksa sends it on around. Carlson towards a goal. Glanced aside by Bonino. Nick Bonino, one of the three goal scorers for Vancouver tonight. Henrik Sedin and Lucas Spiza the others. Brouwer fires this one. Troy Brouwer, a Vancouver native, to the front, deflection try, and Miller slams the door.
Yeah, great look there by Brouwer to Kuznetsov, who's been cruising all around. It's had a real strong game on the puck. Here's a good opportunity. Look at Kuznetsov down low. The shot comes, and look at the quick retrieval. Kuznetsov's going to find him in front of the net. Real good shot there by Brouwer. So Brouwer's puck is retrieved by Kuznetsov. And there it is, thrown right back to him. He can't beat Miller high on that short side.
Faceoff to come in the offensive zone. Burakovsky And Mathias, and Sean Mathias wins it for Vancouver. Cassian drives one in. Mathias is waiting along the boards. Weber's drive, a pad save for Peters, a ricochet to the front. Tipped away by Burakovsky. This is a three-on-one. Ward and O'Brien closing. Liam took his own shot there. It was glanced over top of the bar by Miller.
You would have thought that Spezza would have learned from last game, Joe. He was at the top of the circle, plus he took out one of the forwards. And after you telling us he was minus five the other night, it hasn't stopped him from jumping into the play.
Liam O'Brien, who scored 20 in the Quebec Major Junior League last year, has his first NHL goal tonight. It's a 3-2 Vancouver lead.
And on a three-on-one, you arguably should have a better shot. There should have been a little more puck movement if they didn't realize it was a three-on-one, then it was lack of communication, because they should have moved that puck around to move the goalie a little bit on that shot.
From our vantage point here, it looked like Ryan Miller grazed that just a little. It may have been O'Brien missing the mark over top of the goal as Ovechkin looks to play it out. Daniel Sedin was flattened. Nicholas Backstrom strolls ahead. Backstrom at the attacking line, trailed by Verbata. Backstrom feeds it. Orpik fires. That's blocked. And hit off of Tanev.
And Daniel Sedin off to the bench very slowly with smarting with his left leg.
Dorsett with plenty of jump here. Derek Dorsett right to the front. Justin Peters was waiting. Shots on goal are 25-19 for Vancouver unofficially. Canucks have it. Dangerous chance here for Hansen that was backhanded wide. Bieksa lowers the boom. That's blocked by Ovechkin. Hamus. Bieksa. Slapper. Covered up by Peters. And there's no rebound. Orpik getting into it with Dorsett.
Yeah, they were fencing a little bit with their hockey sticks in the midsection. Looks like it'll calm down a little bit. I'm not sure if any penalties have been doled out here.
Well, when Derek Dorsett's around, he's a former penalty minute champion in the NHL. There's a good bet something's going to be happening. 7 minutes and 20 seconds into the third. Vancouver on top by one on Comcast Sportsnet. Brought to you by Knight Point Systems. They offer the technology you need when you need it. Marcus Johansson lights up against Vancouver.
You can always count on one of the Sedins scoring or getting points. This time it's Henrik, his fourth goal of the season, as he banks one in off the catching glove on the power play.
And the inspirational story that keeps writing itself, Liam O'Brien driving to the front of the net, getting his very first National Hockey League goal, stick on the ice. He'll never forget this game here in Vancouver. And what a story this kid has been, and he continues to play really good hockey every single night.
See Michael Latta immediately going to get that puck. Latta, who scored his first goal in the NHL with Washington against Detroit. Peters makes a stop, rebounds loose, Burrows drags it wide. The follow-up kick back into Peters, he can't cover it. But the Caps have possession, and Brouwer doesn't get out of the zone. Marcus Johansson on the delay. Liam O'Brien an evening ago played a little bit less than 10 minutes against the Flames. Washington picked up win number 4. Bonino, a thorn in the side on this shift, looking for Burrows.
There's going to be another penalty against the Caps.
As Ryan Miller was making his way to the bench, Vancouver goes a man to the good.
I think it's going to be holding the stick here. I'm not sure.
44 Washington minor penalty holding the stick.
Yeah, it's going to be Orpik going. Peters has been terrific, even though three have got by him right off the faceoff. Watch this blast. Then watch the follow-up by Burrows, who's had absolutely no puck luck the last couple of seasons, Joe. Remember last year, real down year, just 5 goals and 15 points. And this is a guy that had racked up a ton of goals over the past couple of years. He's been a 25-goal guy on regularity here in Vancouver.
35 in 09 and 10.
There you go.
These power play stats are packaged by the UBS store. Henrik Sedin wins the draw. Back for Alex Edler. Edler, pump fakes.
That should have been dropped again. And Ward is really upset.
Daniel Sedin fires. Peters looks behind him. The puck is beneath him in the paint for the whistle.
And a takedown in front by Jason Chimera. That last faceoff, you can see Joel Ward talking to the linesman along with Jason Chimera. It was not dropped properly. They weren't set. Here it is. Look at Ward going away. And there it is. That's got to be a redo, as you like to say,
Toby. Redo.
Yeah, look at that. Wardo isn't even down. And look, at he gives it this, and the play continues, leading to that quality chance on the power play.
Let's see if linesman Knorr does any better this time. The Caps get possession, and Niskanen will send Vancouver packing. LA a winner earlier today. Winnipeg just the same. San Jose got the better of Anaheim, and Chicago was victorious over Ottawa. This is the final game of five on the NHL slate. Vancouver in blue. Man advantage for 125. Edler feeds. Henrik Sedin pawns it off to twin brother Daniel. Edler for bottom. Bombs away. That one goes off of the glass and out of play. It'll stay in the offensive zone.
They love hooking this guy up with the shots. 2-year, $5 million deal. He's a 20-goal guy that can rip it. You're not going to see the Sedin shoot the puck a lot on the power play. They're either looking for Edler or they're looking for Vrbata. If the Caps can take away that seam, they'll be much better off as we take a look at our shots on net so far. Brought to you by Jeep Vancouver. 11 better than the Caps at 30-19.
Earlier tonight, we told you the Caps haven't been allowing 30-plus shots to anybody. Vancouver is at 30 and counting, still with 11 minutes to go. Long stretch to Burrows, ripped off by Mike Green. More than halfway through the power play for Vancouver. There's a penalty call coming up. It's against the Canucks. It's interference.
And it's going against Burrows. He knocked down Chimera. Both officials looked at each other. Finally, one guy made the call at center ice. Burrows to the box. Caps will have about a minute nine power play. Top right, middle part of the screen right there. There's Burrows. Notice the official right along there. Far side didn't call it. The up guy did. Burrows to the box.
Knocking down Jason Chimera. So the Caps will have another abbreviated power play. Head coach Willie Desjardins looking on. An associate coach back in the day with the Dallas Stars. Alan May referring to his success with the Medicine Hat Tigers too at the junior level.
And a Calder Cup to boot with Texas.
So here we are, 4-on-4 for 44 seconds. Spezza swings out of his own zone. Henrik Sedin wanders in. Sharp angle bid blasted wide by Daniel. On the carry through center. Weber backtracked there by Evgeny Kuznetsov and Marcus Johansson. Caps will be on the power play in 10 ticks. Johansson finagles in and fanned on the shot. Canucks drive it all the way down. We were still 4-on-4, so that's icing. Icing against Vancouver. Friends, we have McDonald's trivia for you tonight. Concerns Caps netminders. Which goalie holds the record for the highest save percentage in a single season? Single season with a caveat, minimum 25 games. Oh, they love to tweak us with what's in the parentheses that you don't see at home. Minimum 25 games. Best single season save percentage. I have four names on my board.
I don't have any.
You had your list, remember, hashtag Capitals Talk. Who's the best player in the West?
So I don't have this one covered.
Things to ponder. More than halfway through the third period, John Carlson and the Caps trailing by one. Alex Ovechkin has not scored in the last three plus games. Marcus Johansson has one tonight. It was the first one of the contest. Caps led by one, then trailed by two. Carlson steps in and fires. Good blocker save by Ryan Miller.
Really challenging there, well above the paint to take away any space that was behind him.
Johansson, man up Washington, 40 seconds. Carlson this way. Ovechkin pumps that one-timer, blocked. Eaten up by Tannen as he stumbles back into position. Backstrom tees it up for Carlson. Glove save, Ryan Miller.
Yeah, Marcus could not get his stick on that blast from Carlson. He waved it in front of that puck, had it been redirected. That was probably past Ryan Miller. I talked at the top of the show. He's an excellent first shot goaltender. And here's a look at the power and the slap shot. But notice no white jerseys getting to the front, to the sight lines of Mr. Miller.
Johansson, Brouwer, Backstrom, Carlson, Ovechkin, five on ice. Ovechkin one timer, a BB, and Miller makes the save with a blocker. Ovechkin got all of that one.
You know, you look back at the games last year, Ryan Miller in Buffalo playing for the Sabres. And the Sabres had some success against the Capitals, and it was all due to the play of Ryan Miller, 100%.
Whistling drive from Carlson, big ricochet. It caroms to the corner. John Carlson fetches once more. Vancouver back to even strength. Backstrom pulls the trigger. Ooh, Brower had the chance there for deflection.
Uh-oh.
Now the Caps need to get back. It's a two-on-one. Burrows closing. Gets the middle. On his way down. Never pulled the trigger. End-to-end we go. Brower's pass gets away from Johansson, and both teams need a line change. Daniel Sedin brushed it on for Henrik. Takes it right back. Daniel Sedin elevates that puck for Weber. Goal line extended and then some. Crunch there by Mike Green. 5-on-5 play here. 8 minutes to go and some change in regulation time. Spezza, long wrister, stopped. Verbata turns, and Peters got a chunk of that. Luca Spezza has the lead goal for the moment. It was the end of a three-goal run for Vancouver in less than 2 minutes. Back in period two. Crossing over to get it. It's Weber. Bad pass there. Latta was in good position, and he's poke-checked by Verbata, who will dump it in. Radom almost changed to the wrong bench there.
Yeah. A little bit of cross-checking to the empty gate.
Beagle down the alleyway. Jay Beagle taps for Latta. Bulldozed by Tanev, who had an outstanding shot block against Ovechkin during the power play. Oh, my goodness. Richardson was creamed by an Orpik blast.
Right on his right hand. You can hear that all the way up here.
That had to hurt. Rapidly, we are going to look for a trivia question answer. Which Caps goalie holds a record for highest save percentage in a single season?
I'm going with Jim Carrey.
I'll go Varlamov.
I'm going Jim Carrey with you, Locker. I hate to agree with you, but I have to.
And the answer is... All right, maybe someday. The suspense is killing me. Varley.
You spend all day looking that stuff up, Joe.
No.
I know you do.
No. I had four people. I just guessed. Kolzig, Carey, Varlamov, or Theodore. And it was Varlamov. Yes, sir.
By how much?
I think we just showed 924 as the Canucks threaten. A chance there for Higgins. Thousandths of a percentage point, Alan. Thousandths. Through center, Bonino. One against three. Bonino dangles in, looks for Higgins. Back checked by Niskanen. 640 with which to work in the third. Caps need one to tie. A Vancouver team that's dropped three of its last four overall. Niskanen not in a hurry yet. No pressure coming from the forechecker, Hansen. Orpik, who had an assist last night, finds Fair. Fair hit Bay up high with that puck. Ovechkin rumbling back through center. Carlson did not field the pass cleanly as Alsner turns the corner. 5-on-5 play, Fair breezing down the wing. At the line, the Caps would have been offside. Bay on a counterpunch, content to dump it into the Washington zone. 6 minutes to go. Ovechkin, cross rink, Backstrom. 2-on-3. Pulls up and fires. That was muffled. Carlson didn't get a lot of wood on that. It trickles to the doorstep. Henrik Sedin gets help from Tanev. And the Canucks will clear. Back through center. The carom favoring the Caps. Fair drifting wide. Canceled out by Edler. 5-on-5 with 5.5 to go. Radim Verbata drills one in from center. Both teams can change personnel on the go. Mike Green on a lengthy lead trying to spring Brower there. He chases after Yannick Weber. Burakovsky lends support. Bonino pins him to the boards. Brower turns the corner. His saucer pass for Green. Tidying up there was Higgins. As Miller gives the marching orders for Bonino, less than 5 minutes remain in this game. Canucks clearing. Vancouver will play host to Carolina on Tuesday. In the early goings this season, I'm not envious of very much that Carolina has gone through, except one thing. They've got 4 days in Vancouver.
Yeah, but that might tire them out. They may be really not ready for this game come Tuesday night.
It has been a rough go for the Canes.
Rookie parties, all types of things going on, trying to get their season in order. They are a hard-working hockey team, great bunch of guys. The coaches are excellent. They're going to turn it around, just need to get healthy, Jobu.
True. Cassian, 3-on-3. Snapshot swallowed up by Justin Peters. 4 minutes, 14 seconds to go. Stay right there with us. You've stayed up this late on a Sunday night. Come on back with the Canucks in front. Capitals finishing up a road trip. If you get my drift, Deed shows us the road ahead.
Wednesday against the Wings. It'll be covered by our friends at NBCSN. All the action at 7:30. Saturday, we got the Lightning. Sunday, the Coyotes, the Flames, and the Hawks. Good set of home cooking for the Caps upcoming over the next five.
Folks, remember, there are a couple of those games at our CSN Plus. Be sure to check your local listings. Caps and Canucks tonight on Comcast Sportsnet. 4:14 left in regulation time. 3-2 for Vancouver. All the scoring in this game coming in the middle frame. Stay with us. Capitals postgame live presented by your DC area Acura dealers will follow. Al Kokin and Brent Johnson are warming up in the bullpen for that. Centering pass from Chimera, played clear by Verbata. Niskanen and Alsner, the defense pairing for Washington. Coach Desjardins going through a line change for Vancouver as they hang on to a slim one-goal lead. Offside on the dump-in against Washington. Thompson Creek with his window of opportunity. The first NHL marker for number 87.
Love the kid from Halifax, Nova Scotia. Good forecheck. Mike Green pinch and a beautiful redirect. Got to have one more look at this O'Brien. First tally of his National Hockey League career. A thing of beauty all around from the play. He's got a keepsake there. The trainers keep it and safe keeping on the bench. That'll be mounted on a nice plaque ready for him to put up on his fireplace.
Canadian media can't get over the fact he wears number 87. He's from the Halifax Cole Harbor region. They're thinking another 87 in Steeltown. Barry Trotz says, no, it's just the number he was given in training camp. And then he kept surprising everybody through the preseason games and earned himself a spot on the opening night roster.
They take a little heat when the Caps and Pittsburgh Penguins play.
Yeah. Green will dump it in. Miller is there. Quick reverse for Weber. 2:55 left in this third period. We'll keep our eyes on Justin Peters, who's made 30 stops tonight. See when Barry Trotz will take him out of there for the extra attacker. Brouwer, Burakovsky, Johansson on ice now, looking for the equalizing tally. As Hanson carefully goes off the boards, Dorsett will bang it ahead. Brooks Orpik threads that one for Johansson, picked off by Hanson.
Nice play by Hanson, defensively closing off the center of the ice here at Rogers Arena.
John Carlson will dump it in from center. Ryan Miller gets into the act. Chimera on the steal. He anticipated that wraparound nicely. Verbata does it clear. Along the boards, Kuznetsov fanned on the puck. Verbata will chip it back to the Washington line. 2 minutes to go. Orpik swings. Long stretch to Ward. Bumps at Kuznetsov. He's in. Splitting the defense. But Miller turned it away as Kuznetsov was knocked to his knees. Higgins on the fly down the flank from Vancouver. Chris Higgins slams on the brakes. Lost it there to Carlson with 1:38 to go. There's a stoppage in play.
And the Vancouver Canucks are asking for a
delay of game.
Yes, if it's inside the blue, it doesn't matter. And that is going to be a delay of game, Joby, right on. That's what I thought they were asking for. And it's a delay of game. Caps get caught here because Kuznetsov, great opportunity on that last rush up the ice, but John Carlson to the box. The puck was only about 10 feet inside the blue, Joe, and any part of the inside the blue, you throw it up and over the glass, you're doomed. So now it's penalty killing time on the Carlson delay of game.
That's a backbreaker with just
is.
1:38 to go in the contest.
The puck got rolling on him. He tried to throw it off the glass and it goes up and over.
That's the voice of Craig Lochlin. I'm Joe Beninati. Alan May has been inside the glass tonight. These power play stats are packaged by the UPS store. Top of the hour, just about Monday morning back home. Washington is trailing 3-2. They're shorthanded. Late in regulation time. Justin Peters marches to the bench. So that makes it 5-on-5 hockey. Alex Ovechkin comes on for the goaltender. The long clear out. Backstrom interchanging with Niskanen. 1:12 to go in the game. Green scales it wide of Ryan Miller. In hot pursuit is Eric Fair. Fair to the front, nobody there. Verbata towards the open goal. On target, bullseye. Radim Verbata.
That was a gutsy call by Verbata to throw the puck all the way from down there. The reason being it would have been an ice had it continued to roll in the right direction, and it would have been a faceoff in front of their goaltender. Here he is, errant pass by Fair. It's going to be unassisted by Verbata. Enough mustard, enough touch as it rolls into the net.
Locker and Allen, how many times do you see a puck roll on edge like that and stay straight?
I know, unbelievable.
Well, Every time you guys do it, it curves.
Yeah, when things are going well for you, when the puck's going in the back of the net, those things happen. And you know what? That was a very gutsy move, like Locker said, but you know what? I'm in total agreement of sending those pucks down the ice just to get it out of trouble rather than playing it too safe.
44 seconds with which to work now. Justin Peters is still on the bench for Washington as Green skates in. His feet blocked off there. Defensively, Hamhuis has been strong. Another pot shot towards the empty goal. This goes wide, and it is icing against Vancouver.
Yeah, Higgins tried to add on to their score to add to the fifth goal. It's 4-2 now here in the third.
Folks, we are going to go with this evening's Caps Player of the Game, sponsored by the Palm Restaurant, with his first NHL tally, number 87.
Got to go with him, right, Mayday?
Yeah, you know what? He and Peters.
Yeah,
forget that. You want to win the game, but for him to get his first, and he has had a great road trip. He's been solid every night, and a great reward for him.
Enter to be the Palm Fan of the Month at thepalm.com/fan. Capitals offside on the entry. Washington in 20 seconds time will fall to 4-2-2. Vancouver will improve to 5-3. The Canucks opening a three-game homestand.
Yeah, big difference between 1-2 and 2-1 on the road. They had to get that first game, then they'd probably be going 2-1 home now. Now they're 1-2, having to regroup for Wednesday night against Detroit.
The trip began with a one-goal loss in Edmonton. Success last night in Calgary. And now falling to Vancouver. As this drive goes wide of the cage, Tanev was looking for the empty netter. Icing against Vancouver.
Following Alan May's philosophy, just fire it down there. Who cares if there's a faceoff?
And it must be their coaches, because they continue to do it. He's not acting like it's bothering him on the bench. And he might have some good numbers on this as to where it's at. In a very well-coached game tonight, the Capitals weren't able to get any pucks through the neutral zone with a lot of speed. And you know what, the Vancouver Canucks, they're still fast on offense, but on defense, they were exceptional tonight.
Back to point position for Green. Wrister on the way, floats wide of Miller. The Washington Capitals haven't won here since 2001. It encompasses six games now. Vancouver is in the win column with a 4-2 decision.
Often the problem with rested teams. Vancouver was waiting for the Caps. The Caps flew in last night, late night. Their first period was not very good. They recovered in the second, but then Vancouver turned it around in the third, and the Caps are doubled up 4-2 here in Vancouver.
Locker and I and Allen have a little bit more work to do. Please do stay there with us. Ryan Miller and the Vancouver Canucks, 4-2 victors on home ice north of the border. Back after these words on CSN.